Thanks for joining us again for our coverage of the 2008 Olympics. This week has certainly lived up to the hype that was coming into these games, and Huntington continues its place on the world stage. We're coming to you live from the LNBC Octagon, where the synchronized swimming event already is in full swing, and we've seen some strong performances. Now let's go to the pool and talk to Andy Backus and Corky Thompson, who are preparing for their first ever synchronized swimming event. Now, Andy and Corky, I know this is your first time competing in this event at this level. If you could just describe for me the journey that it's taken to this moment.
Well, Dan, for me, there were several major obstacles to overcome. You had to start with my morbid fear of water. I really have to give all the credit to Dr. Tim Yates and his years of counseling that he was able to jam into 37 days for me to learn to at least get into a shower. Then from there, I had to learn to swim and exercise and some basic dental hygiene, and we were ready for the Olympics.
Now you, Corky, you can describe.
And as for me, I've always wanted to win a medal, and I jog. People know me in the neighborhood as the runner, and I thought I was getting pretty good, and I said, well, I can maybe join the Olympics, get in the Olympics and run. And then I watched the last Olympics and realized that I wasn't an Ethiopian, so I didn't stand a chance of winning. So I decided synchronized swimming. I said, that's not bad. That's an event that I believe anybody can do. But I've had a bad water experience. When Barbara and I first got married, we had a waterbed, and we just about got a divorce over it because for some reason we just kept drifting apart, you know, and we had to get rid of it, and that really helped. But I think I'm like Andy. I've overcome that fear, and I'm ready to try.
Okay, well, it sounds like you guys are just about ready to begin your routine, so let's go ahead and meet our judges for today's event. From the beautiful state of South Carolina, a world traveler, guardian of orphans, and wife of missions expert Reverend Doug Hodges, Mrs. Paula Hodges. From the promised land of Georgia, one of the region's finest pianists and wife of renowned Bible expositor and TV preacher, Dr. David Lemming, Mrs. Mary Lemming. And finally, from right here in Huntington, West Virginia, a woman who has been let out of the home for today and who claims to be the wife of best-selling author Dr. Tim Yates, Mrs. Magsy. We've already seen some strong performances tonight, and currently the duo from Argentina holds the lead. Team USA is hoping they can change that with a strong performance of their own. All right, it looks like our swimmers are just about ready to begin. Looks like a pretty strong start for the team. Some coordinated arm movements. A little bit out of sync there. Perhaps they can recover. They're facing into the doing some mirror action. That's a nice move. We've seen that from some other teams. Oh, a point. We have not seen a point yet. That is brand new to this competition. And we've got some patty cake going on. Oh, no. Nobody saw that coming. Andy completely missed Corky's hand. Now they're trying to bring it back home with a swim stroke move here. I'm not sure, though. It's looking rough at this point. They may not be able to recover. And they're finishing with a little snorkel move, it looks like. Well, that's a disappointing turn of events, but we'll have to see what our judges say. Right now, I believe our judges are going to be tabulating their scores. It's going to take just a few moments for them to do that. They are working feverishly down there, trying to decide exactly what scores to give to this team. Again, it's their first ever competition, so they're hoping for the best.
Well, personally, I thought that they were very, very good, except a few mistakes. But so I'm going to give them a 1.75. However, I think that the one that's named Corky is going to bring this out. I think with a name like that, they will win. All right, go Corky!
Well, I thought that they did superb. Their physiques, everything. I was so pleased. I give them a 5.25. I've never seen such a thing in my life like that, and I was very impressed. I was really excited about it. Yeah, I have been adding here on this calculator. It's not a him, it's a her. And I give them the score of 2.50. Now, reason is because I like that colored water that came out at the end. It was kind of yellow there for a while.
Well, clearly these scores were not what this team had hoped for coming into tonight. We really need to go back to poolside here and get Team USA's perspective on what's happened here. It's a shocking turn of events.
Well, you know, coming in, I was a little concerned about the depth of the pool. Our practice pool is not nearly this deep. And to be completely honest with you, I think it threw me off a little bit.
Now, Corky, what do you think kept you guys out of sync?
Well, I'm not sure. I'll have to see the replay and... I think it was and you know, he has ADD, and I think he was struggling with the water more so than the routine, so we'll have to see the replay.
Well, everyone had high hopes for this duo. Unfortunately, they weren't quite able to get the job done today. But now we'd like to introduce you to a couple who many are saying will set world records.